Hey guys, it's Dragon Ball for Life here today, and I'm back with another video. Now, today's video, we're going to be talking about Hancock and how strong he is. John Hancock from the Hancock movie. Now, this character, the thing about him is, he's quite interesting. Now, when I was doing my research and I tried to search up which comic book, you know, company was he from, I assumed that he was from like a smaller publishing company, like, you know, you see from like Variant or Dark Horse or something like that, not tied in directly to the bigger, you know, comic book industries like Marvel or DC. But from what I found out and when I searched up online, it stated he was a Marvel character. Though I don't think that is true. There wasn't any evidence showcasing that. There was no comic book issue showing Hancock from, you know, Marvel or showing a database for Marvel. He seems like more of a, you know, movie original character. Like, the movie was the only time his character was created, which, if I'm being honest, that's quite interesting. Because usually characters, when we have superpowered characters, they're from a comic book company. Even if it's a small one, they're from some specific comic book company. It's very rare that you would find, you know, a superhero S character that's originally made from a movie. So I do think that's pretty cool. But that also means that there isn't going to be too much crazy information I can get from any other source. The only source I need is this movie, which is great for me because that means all I have to do is really watch this movie and, you know, gain the clips from the movie itself. So that makes it a lot easier to deal with the, you know, this as a whole. But yeah, this movie, the thing about it is we're not going to have any real high-end feats for, you know, Hancock. And by high-end feats, I mean where his limits lie. Because usually to find out a character's limitations, you have to put them in, you know, the toughest situations that pushes them past their limit. But the thing in this movie is he wasn't really pushed past his limit at any real specific point. He did have a fight with another superpowered character, which is the only other superpowered character, which is Mary, played by Charlize Theron's character, actress. And that battle wasn't even that long, and it wasn't a full-on-out battle, so we still don't know, like, the limits to it. So I'm going to try my best. So the first scene that we see in this movie is him sleeping on a bench. A kid wakes him up because there's these criminals that's, like, robbed a bank or something, and they're in a getaway car. And he has to go stop them. So he gets up, he flies, he's flying at like super speed. You know, he's hitting into birds, he dodges an airplane. And then he's flying towards the place. He's able to easily tear off the roof of the car, get inside the vehicle, talk to the guys a little bit, and then they start shooting at him and it just bounces off of him. He doesn't even flinch, he's completely bulletproof. And they destroy his glasses and his alcohol bottle, which pisses him off. So he sticks his feet through the car into the ground, you know, stabbing right into the cement and just breaking off the road itself and stopping the vehicle as a whole. And he is pissed at this point. He lifts up the entire car, which is, it seems to be an SUV, which are more heavier than regular cars. He's lifting it up with one hand, casually moving around, messing with it until he gets blinded by, you know, the helicopter lights. Drops the thing and then flies down, picks it up before it hits the ground, gets it up and smashes it through a building. So this showcases a couple of stuff from his, you know, his power side already. One, we can see that he has, you know, flight. Two, we see he has super strength. And three, we see he has enhanced durability. His durability from this showcases that he's bulletproof, very casually. His strength showcases that he can easily lift a car up with one hand, which an average car would weigh like a ton or maybe 2 tons. This car would probably be like around like 4 tons something, right around there. And he's casually able to lift it up with one hand. So we know he's in the multi-ton range when it comes to strength. And this is casually lifting up something like, you know, a car. Also the fact that, you know, he was able to, you know, pick it up and slam it through the thing. Also, I don't know how fast he would have to be for the car falling down and him to catch it before he got it. I would have to do quite a bit of math, you know, the amount of acceleration a car would be falling down in, and, you know, the speed that you would have to go from the distance that he was grabbing it. But I'm not going to do all that. I would say that, you know, it would be, like, maybe hundreds of miles per hour. I wouldn't put it at, like, Mach speeds, but he could definitely move at Mach speeds if he can dodge, you know, an airplane coming at him. So that was also pretty interesting. Then after this, we have, you know, we have Will Smith, the main character in this movie. Well, the other main character, Jason Bateman, I think his name is. His character, I forgot what his name was in the movie. He was basically, there was a bunch of cars piled up in traffic and they're stuck in a, you know, a train away. And as they were stuck in the trainway, the train was about to come and hit his car. He couldn't move backwards or forwards because the cars were stuck. So Hancock came in there to save him. He jumps in the middle, lifts up his car casually and tosses it over, and then the train comes in and he embraces and it smashes into him, stopping the train. This seems like a cargo train, and also the other like cargo parts of the train fall over, and it seemed pretty long. It seemed like it had like 18 different like cargo carrying stuff, and it fell over and it destroyed the area and knocked over poles and stuff. This one is a very impressive strength feat, him being able to lift and casually flip a car like it's nothing, then also get hit by a train and stop it dead on. And this is like a big carrier train that had multiple different carts connected to it. So this would be, I don't know how much, I'll probably put up a number somewhere talking about how much weight it would be, but or find a statistic or how heavy it should be that he should stop it. But still, he was able to stop a train that was going at full speed with that much amount of mass. He can easily tank a train colliding into him, and it didn't even make him flinch at all, showcasing insane level of durability and also strength there. He also lifts up the guy's car and drops it once again, casually showcasing he can easily lift up cars in this franchise. After this, he talks with the guy, and the guy's like, I want to clean up your image, make it better. So he's showcasing him some videos of him, video footage of some of the stuff that he did. One where he stopped, a burning building and burned off his clothes. And he's like, yeah, my body was hot. I was burning up. That's why I had to get the ice cream and stuff. Which would put it in, one, he can handle, he has heat resistance and he can handle heat from, a whole house fire. But the thing that we need to take to note is what he stated, his statement about, he got heated up. Obviously, it wasn't enough to severely hurt him, but he can also still feel heat. So he would have somewhat of a limitation with that, but we just don't know to what extent. Then we see later on, another video of him trying to save this beached whale, and it looked like a humpback whale. He lifts up the whale and casually tosses it hundreds of meters away. Easily hundreds of meters away, and these whales should weigh somebody said that this is an infant whale. I don't think this is an infant whale. It seems like a normally sized adult whale, and those ones were around 200 tons, a little bit over 200 tons, and he was able to casually toss it. So now he's in the hundreds of tons range and easily able to toss that, which would make it even harder. So probably thousands of tons range to be able to throw something of this size at that distance and that speed. It was just, it was just crazy. After this, we see him, going to the prison to do the reform thing. He has a whole line of other guys, 12, 13 other guys behind him, and he casually walks and is able to drag them easily. He does do some crazy other stuff, he's able to use his fingernail to cut out the glass that he's behind, talk to the other guy, and he even breaks off this door off of his hinges, casually able to, hop back and forth. He has all super jumping and stuff. We see crazy stuff like that. There wasn't too much crazy stuff for there, but then after that, when he, gets out of the prison and they need his help, he comes into a very dangerous situation where, there's these guys taking over this bank and they had hostages, and they're shooting at this police officer lady. He comes in to save her. He lifts up a car casually with one hand, using it as a protective shield for her, and then he breaks in there and takes out the guys by flying. He flies so fast that he basically speed blitz them and is able to take all these guys out until it's the last final guy who has a dead man switch. Now, to take this guy out with the dead man switch to not, kill the people there, he gets this one metal thing on this lap or something. He gets it off, flattens it, puts his fingernails and is able to rip off the edges, making it sharper, and tosses it at such a speed that it decapitates the guy's hand off of him. And he gets taken away in prison. This is cool. This is interesting because, one, it showcases how fast he is able to speed blitz multiple people back and forth. Two, showcasing, his, level durability, his body deflecting all types of machine gun fire, and even deflecting, a rocket that came at him with just the palm of his hand. Also being able to, take out the, make the edges of this metal thing, sharp, and then cut off the guy's hand. That's also pretty impressive. But one thing I do want to, talk with you guys is, does Hancock have super speed? Because from what I've seen is he's had super strength, invulnerability, high amount of stamina, longevity, flight, and you just super strength, stuff like that. But he doesn't have any other stuff. He doesn't have any energy projection. He doesn't have psychic abilities. and he doesn't have, he might not have super speed. And the reason why I say that is if he did have super speed, he wouldn't need to do this contrived way of, you know, flattening the thing and chopping off his hand. Because if he did have super speed, he could have easily just gotten over there, grabbed the thing, and then took the Dead Man Switch out of his hand so he couldn't use it. But he didn't do that. And the only times we see him move very fast is when he's flying. So, I don't know. Does he have super speed only when it comes to flying, but regular speed? Like, I'm talking about, like running or, you know, his reflexes. But then again, he did deflect a grenade launcher, which I don't know how fast that would be moving, but it would possibly be moving pretty fast. Also, we don't see him really catching bullets. So, I don't know. Does he have super speed or super fast reflexes? He should have some level to advance, you know, reflexes. But I don't know if it would be on the super, like, side, like what you see with Superman or the Flash or characters like that. So, that was kind of interesting because, like I said, if he did have super speed, instead of having to do that contrived way of, you know, stopping him from pressing the trigger, he could have just moved so fast that he grabbed it from his hand and had it with him. And there's a little more to it to that too. Later on, after this, we see him coming to the guy's house, and Charlize Theron's character, which we find out she's like him. Apparently, they're both gods. They were considered gods and even angels at some point. Now they're considered superheroes. She was just in hiding, where he was more out and about, and she wants him out of her life for whatever reason, and they kissed, and he thought he was about to kiss her again, but she grabs him, tosses him through her house, smashing through the, you know, refrigerator, and smacking him into a car. So she's able to easily, you know, toss around Hancock. And she even reveals something interesting, saying that that there was multiple different other gods, but they all died, and they're the last two, but she is the strongest, she's stronger than him, which I don't believe, and you'll see what I mean by that. But she was able to casually toss him around, and then he wants to talk to her. He's like, you better talk to me about what is happening, what are we and stuff, or I'm going to tell your husband. And she doesn't want her husband to find out, so she's trying to talk with him, but it goes wrong because she doesn't want to divulge, like, all of the, you know, information. So he's like, you know what, screw it, I'm going to go tell him anyway. They get into a little scuffle. He flies off first, she smashes him into, like, you know, he's there in, you know, California. She smashes him to one of, like, the mountain range areas. He destroys it. He lands onto the city, destroys the street there, is able to, like, destroy it. She lifts up a cement truck and smashes it down on him. And as they're fighting, the weather starts to change. It seems like whenever these godly beings would fight, there's some cataclysmic, you know, event that happens. Because there's these giant, gray clouds coming, thunder striking, then giant tornadoes on the ground. There was, like, multiple tornadoes with lightning coming out of it. And then they're creating a snowstorm a little bit. And it was just, like, it seemed more, like, apocalyptic. Which is cool, because if you were to assume two godly beings fighting, you would assume that these godly beings would have some, catastrophic type of level event stuff. So this seemed pretty, you know, like, divine, like, level. And then they're smashing each other through stuff. He's grabbing her, and then he holds her down, and he basically stops her. She's more aggressive towards him. She's not trying to kill him, and I don't know if she can, but she was just trying to really hurt him, whereas he was trying to constrain her and just, like, trying to calmly talk to her, like, what's happening. He was a little bit annoyed, but she was completely pissed because he called her crazy. And this is why I don't believe that she is stronger than him. Because if she was technically stronger than, Hancock, she wouldn't have been able to get out of it, but he was able to hold her down. So I don't agree with this, that I think that was her just lying or being cocky or whatever. But yeah, I don't take that whole she's stronger than him, because this disproves it. And there's also another statement that she makes later on in the hospital, which even further to me proves that that statement is just not correct. So, yeah, we have this little fight. This is, like, the most that he got pushed to, because he's actually fighting as somebody that's on his level. The rest of the people are just regular dudes with guns and knives and bombs and stuff, which is impressive, but, like, let's be honest, we haven't seen the highest extent to what he can do. And there's some stuff I want to talk about towards the ending of where his limitations could lie and more about his character, because, sadly, we never got a second movie and we never got an in-depth, full-on story on, you know, how it his powers work and stuff. So after this, we have Hancock being a little depressed, you know, the whole fight thing with her, and the other guy finding out, and it's just a little bit of a problem. So he's going to get some alcohol from a store, and as he's doing it, the guy that's there is getting robbed by this one dude. He has a gun, and he's basically pointing the gun at actually two dudes. He picks up one of the guys, casually tosses him, and smashing into the glass casing where the alcohol or usually just the drinks are. He smashes him through that. The other guy puts a gun to the shopkeeper's head, and he's trying to talk to him. He's like, okay, you want to take whatever you want, then stop me. He picks up a candy bar, flicks it so hard, it smashes the guy through the window. Crazy level of strength, the fact that he's able to use a candy bar. Like, the candy bar was so strongly thrown that it was able to send a grown man flying and smashing through a glass window, knocking him out. Insanely, powerful. Though, once again, this does kind of feed into the argument that he does not have super speed when it comes to his, you know, his natural movements, not talking about flying. Because if he did, he could have just done what the Flash would do, which would be speed blitzing him, you know, going there, instantly knock him out, or taking the gun out of his hand, you know, like we normally see, but he didn't do that. So I think that's one of his superpowers that he does not have, which is quite interesting to give somebody super speed when it comes to flying, but not naturally their other movements. That's just weird. Then we go to, he gets hurt and he goes to the hospital. But the only reason he got hurt was we get revealed throughout the hospital scene, which does give us the most, historical background. And it's important to have history in the background because when we have this, we understand more about his power and to the extent. So from what she explained is there was multiple of them. She didn't explain how many. They were created as godly beings to protect the humans of this world. And they come in pairs, and it's just their relationships. So his pair was, Mary. And they come in pairs, they become lovers. But the thing is, when they come together, normally they're super powerful and they have all these powers. But when they come together, they lose their powers and they become mortal. So the only way to hurt or seriously kill these guys is if they're around each other, and thus getting rid of their immortality, making them mortal. And once when they're mortal, they can be easily killed by, other people. Because what she explained was they all got together and a bunch of the village people came with swords and basically killed all the other gods except for them two. They got away, and throughout history, they would just try to travel together. They'd probably separate and, live longer and then come back together. And they were around for thousands of years. She mentioned they all died in, I think she said 4 BC in Sumer, which was the first original civilization, which is crazy. They're that old. But yeah, all the way over there. So yeah, these guys were, the other gods were only killed, and they were considered gods and then angels and now superheroes because of modern day. But the only reason they were killed was because they came together making them mortal and then killed by conventional weapons like swords. But besides that, they cannot die. She was talking about historical times where they were together and every time he saved her life, and every time he did save her life, his life was in danger. He nearly died. We do see scars on his chest, throughout his entire body. And from what we know now is when he does separate himself from her, they become like immortal beings. So he does regenerate the damages they took, because in Brooklyn, he got his skull cracked and he got his head fully fixed. And that was like 80 years ago. So they also live super long. But yeah, they regenerate. But the thing about it is what damage they got before when they were mortals stays even when they go back to the immortality. It doesn't leave, because he has all these scars around his body throughout these different times and events that stick around. So yeah, he will be back to, regenerate to, a healthy amount, but still keep this battle damage and, the scars that he had previously. So like, maybe if he lost like a limb, like an arm or something, or a leg, and he got immortality, maybe it would just cauterize the arm and he would be armless, which, that might be the case. But yeah, we see that. And then these guys try to come in, try to kill him while he's vulnerable. He picks up a bed and crosses through the building, destroys it. And he's able to casually throw these guys throughout windows and stuff. Even though he is depowered, he does still have a level of durability, because he takes quite a bit of, shots from, bullets, getting hit with a big heavy metal thing to his face. And he's able to casually toss people and still stuff. So he does still have his, feet, his powers and strengths. It's just to a lot lower level. And from what we've shown by her is that when they're around each other, they're very, very more limited, in their powers, and to a point where they become completely mortal. It's kind of like Superman with the Red Sun. People think of a red sun comes out, he automatically loses powers. No, it takes time. It takes him a whole day. So I don't know how long it takes for him, but at some point they will be completely be mortal, and they could get seriously hurt. So, but at this time, he was still strong enough to, you know, handle it. Also, she did reveal the fact that he was the hero of the gods, so he was the heroic type, so maybe he was the most powerful one. And that kind of, once again, makes me, you know, discredit her statement where she stated that she was stronger than him, because once again, if she was stronger than him, he wouldn't want to fight, and two, he wouldn't be the hero of the gods, she would be. So the fact that he was the heroic example of the gods and made specifically for that, you know, it contradicts that. So yeah, he does show a level of durability where he can handle that. And then in the end of the movie, we do get the most impressive feat from Hancock throughout this entire film, and that was him tagging the Hearts Foundation logo, which was the other guy, you know, Mary's husband, I forgot once again what his name was, you know, his little thing that he was trying to do and promote. He puts the Hearts logo on the moon itself. He flies to the moon and does it and comes back to Earth. Now, we don't know how long it took him, because they just stated, he just showed it to him. He's like, hey, look, we don't know when he did it and what time and stuff, how long it took him, so I don't know about that, but it's still impressive that he was able to fly all the way to the moon, which is, I think like around 200,000, 300,000 miles away, to go to the moon and then come all the way back and also paint mostly the surface of the moon, which is quite impressive. So yeah, that was definitely his best, you know, feat. Also, this might put into the argument that he can also survive in a vacuum, not needing to breathe. Who knows, maybe he probably did what Superman used to do, where he held his breath and he went up and stuff. Or he could simply just not need to breathe. So that could also be a thing. They state that multiple times that they are immortals. So we don't know if they means that with their powers, that when, you know, when they're not together, that means that these guys are unkillable or unbeatable, or like, you know, he has, you know, just complete invulnerability, or it just means that compared to the rest of the people, it's so high, because the conventional weapons they have, the highest you can have is a nuke, but still, that doesn't mean that he could survive planet destroying attacks, but also that doesn't mean he can't. So it's kind of iffy there. That's what I mean by, we don't know his exact limits. If this was a universe where there's other superpowered beings, we could have had more of him fighting against other people, seeing how powerful he would be. But since they're just really humans, there isn't really the limits that you could put is just, you know, cars, like him lifting up stuff as cars or buildings, and for like damaged guns, explosions, and maybe a nuke at the highest. But we didn't see anything on that level. So yeah, I just want to talk about, let's go through some of his stuff. So what he has is superpowers from what I've seen. Super strength, super flight, enhanced durability, longevity, and super stamina. Those are the only powers that I've seen him have. When it comes to his strength, he's casually able to lift up cars with a single hand so easily, and I think his best strength feat was definitely, you know, tossing that humpback whale hundreds of meters away, which would weigh like, you know, hundreds of tons, and that would put it in the thousands of tons range, and especially Mary picking up a cement truck and smashing it down on him, that's also pretty impressive. For durability, also I think him flicking the candy bar super hard is also pretty impressive. For durability, I would say the fact that we saw him deflecting bullets, getting cars smashed on top of him, getting smacked through buildings and stuff, especially getting smacked through these big buildings, he can survive that without any damage. I would say the most impressive thing was definitely him getting hit by the train, showcasing that he could take that much amount of kinetic force, you know, that much of mass at that speed hitting him, which would have a high amount of kinetic force hitting him and tanking that without even flinching. For his flight speeds, we don't know how fast he is. I think the best feat was him going to the moon, but we can't really have calculation because we do have a distance, but we don't know the amount of time it took for him to get to there and back and the amount of time it took for him to paint. So he could be at, you know, massively hypersonic or even light speed, but we just don't know. That's the only thing. But when it comes to super speed in general, like not flying, we don't have really anything for there, for that. But yeah, from also what it seems like, he can't get sick. He does have heat resistance. He doesn't, you know, he has some form of regeneration also to him. So he has quite a bit of other abilities. He's quite a unique character. I just want to learn more. Like, for example, they talked about him and her being gods. I want to know who created these gods. Why were they created? Who created them? Were there other superpowered beings out there? You know, why were they killed? Like, like, was God, did God create them to be the protectors? What is he in the, you know, mythos and history? Somebody said that he was Zeus and that she was supposed to be, you know, Zeus's wife. But I don't believe that because he doesn't showcase anything on Zeus. Like, he doesn't showcase lightning abilities. So I highly doubt that. And usually the Greek gods were always hanging around each other and around each other. So if he was around his wife all the time, he would be mortal. So he wouldn't be able to showcase his, you know, his unbelievable amount of power. So yeah, I just don't know that. Maybe it could be Gilgamesh. Who knows? Maybe, you know, Will Smith could have been Gilgamesh, the first superhero in all of history. That could be an interesting little fun story, you know. But yeah, there's just not enough we know about this character. A couple of stuff I wanted to know was, one, could he, you know, survive going into the sun? Could he survive, you know, gamma radiation, you know, going into deep space? Could he go to different planets and stuff, come around, you know, do all this crazy stuff? I want to see more of his limitations, what he could do, and how he would fare up against other powerful, you know, beings. But for right now, his feats aren't that impressive. They're nothing too crazy, but that's just because of where he, you know, the world he lives in. If he had more powerful characters, we could have probably seen more impressive feats, but this is the most we could see, and sadly, we never got a second movie. We would probably never get a second movie, and I don't know if he's from another comic book, company or whatever, but yeah, that's all I had for him. I think he's quite an interesting character. Comment down in the comment section below, what do you guys think about Hancock? Do you think, what do you think about the movie? What do you think about Will Smith's performance? What do you think about the idea of him? What do you want to see more? Would you want to see more? Personally, I enjoyed the movie. I do think that whole, the wife and, you know, them being mortal stuff is kind of stupid. I don't like that thing. I think Will Smith, even though he's a great actor, I don't think he was that great in this movie, because a lot of times when he tried to act tough, he just scrunched his face up and like made a weird looking face and looked like he smelled something bad, like he walked into a bathroom to smell like some foul shit or something like that. So I wasn't really a big fan of his acting. Charlize Theron, she did pretty good. Jason Bateman, I think his name is, he did a really good job, but him, I would say it's really weird. Some parts were really awkward. I do love the whole good job one, good job. That seemed pretty funny. I want to know more about his character and stuff, especially the godly stuff. And if there's a comic book issues about him, please tell me, because I really want to, you know, do more on this. But yeah, that's it for John Hancock. I want to know from you guys, who do you think would be the best perfect matchup for Hancock? Like, who do you think is not too OP compared to him or too weak compared to him? Who do you think would be the perfect person? Because I wouldn't put Superman. I think he's too strong. I think you need somebody more on his level. But yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I really liked the movie. I think it was really great. It did make me kind of sad that they didn't have like a sequel to it. I think that would have been amazing. And one of the most interesting thing is this movie came out in 2008. At this time, you know, The Incredible Hulk came out and, you know, the first Iron Man movie came out. So they were really building up the MCU. So it sucks that this movie didn't get like bigger. Also, this movie was far more, you know, adult. Like than the Marvel movies, because it had cursing, it had like sex, it had like, you know, more graphic violence and stuff. Not to a crazy extent, but still more, which surprised me. I was like, damn, really? Like, it's just crazy. But yeah, it was quite an interesting movie. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and stay tuned for next time.